Very good morning. I can remove the mask, no?
Yes. A friend of mine told me a very wonderful, very touching anecdote. He said when he was a small kid, one of his friends offered that I will lend you my bicycle for one day. You can enjoy yourself on that. And next morning I'll come and collect it. He said it was one of the most thrilling days of my life because I didn't have a bicycle. So I got this bicycle and I started riding it. The whole day I thoroughly enjoyed myself. I went all over the place with the bicycle. At the end of the day, I came back and I put it away. The moment I woke up in the morning, the first thought that struck me is, today I will not have the bicycle because my friend is coming to pick it up. I had time. I could have got onto that bicycle, but I said, if I start using the cycle and this fellow comes, I will have to immediately stop and give it to him and I'll feel bad. So let me just wait for him to come. He said, I spent the whole day not using the bicycle, getting very upset and depressed and all that, that what a wonderful day yesterday was. Today I won't have the bicycle, he'll take it away, etc. The whole day went past. His friend didn't come to pick up the bicycle. The second day, the third day, and the fourth day. On the fourth day, the friend came, took the cycle and went away. Now these three extra days that I had, he said, I didn't touch the cycle because of the fear that my friend will come and take it away. He said, that is what is happening to us with regard to the fear that we have developed. And he said it so simply and beautifully in Hindi, ke zindagi char din ki hai, jeevan char din ka hai. Enjoy yourself, you have that bicycle. And when the owner of that bicycle, that is, when the Yamdut or whatever it is, comes to take it away, happily hand it over to him. That is your life. Now that is what life is all about. And unless we learn how to face life, we will only be scared of death all the time. We'll be, you know, mortally be in fear. Yes, I do understand that because of the pandemic and that there are a lot of restrictions and we need to take a lot of precautions. I've got nothing against people who are propagating precautions. In fact, I agree with them, right? From the government regulations down to social obligations and all that, fulfill it. But we must understand that life has to go on. We cannot put life on hold. When I hear people saying, I will do something only when the vaccine comes. Let the vaccine come, let the vaccine not come. Life goes on, is it? Every day life is there for you. Now, are you making the best of your life or not? That becomes the question. If you are making the best of your life, you are living life to its fullest every day. It does not matter how many days I have left for my life. It is the quality of life that matters. That is something that we are missing out. If the experts say children should not be sent to school, they are wise people. They have been saying it probably fully knowing what is best for them. We will oblige. We will stick to whatever has been told to us. That does not mean that the child's learning has to stop. It does not mean that the child's interactions, family life, whatever social, emotional development has to stop. And it is not restricted to children. What about adults? There are so many adults who put their life on hold. Some of them are working from home, but that's fine. Whether you're working from home or you're working physically going to office or not, that's only one part of your life, isn't it? Life is much more than what you do in your workplace. What about that? Now that some changes have come in, some restrictions have come in, how do I adapt myself to it? As I mentioned earlier also, I don't like this idea or concept of people saying this is the new normal. Please, ladies and gentlemen, this is not normal. This is the new abnormal. I protest. This is not what life is going to be. I'm not going to spend the rest of my life locked in to the four walls of my house. and I will not make my family also do it. I will do it only till it is absolutely necessary, only till the protection has to be given. And how long is it going to be? That is like the story of the cycle. It may be tomorrow morning, it may be 4 days from now, it may be 4 years from now. It doesn't matter. I'm not going to be sitting around waiting for that vaccine to come. I'm going to make the best of what life is. And what do I need in order to do that? All I need is to learn some basic life skills. I need to learn how to make the best of my life. I need to understand not only as an individual, but as a functioning member of my immediate family, my extended family, my neighborhood, my city, my state, my country, and the entire world. I am a citizen of the world. I have to interact with people. I have to learn how to deal with different type of people. I've always been saying that according to me, a good quality of life, good mental health, whatever well-being is peace within yourself and harmony with others. Am I maintaining that peace within my own self? Am I in harmony with others? Logistics is only a small part of it. Just because I may not be able to go and visit my old uncle because he's scared of infection and he's not meeting anybody, does not mean that I have to cut him off from my life if he's valuable to me. If I feel that he is an important person and I would like to maintain a good bond with him, I can always do it without physically going in his presence. There are 100 ways of doing it. Because thankfully, luckily, this pandemic has come when the communication, the technology is giving us access to anybody in any part of the globe. Now, what do I do? How do I lead my life? How do I make the most of it? I have my physical needs. I need exercise. My body cannot be shut down and locked up in my apartment. I have to make sure that I get physical activity. More than that, I need mental activity. I need emotional activity. And I need spiritual activity. So what am I doing with regard to that? This is the question which I want all of you to please give serious thought to it, because we do not know how long this pandemic is going to last. More than the pandemic, I don't know how long this fear factor and these restrictions are going to last. So let us ensure that we work towards these life skills. We teach life skills to ourselves, our family members, our children, whoever is in touch with us. These are very, very basic things. It's not rocket science that I'm talking about. We can all learn, we can all practice it with a few simple things. Even if you are overworked, you are one of those people who's working 12 hours a day, WFH, or you're one of those homemakers who is juggling between your work, your children, your cooking, your kitchen, and all that, you can still manage to push in these life skills. They are not time consuming. They are not adding to your burden. You can do it. So for that, we have devised certain very simple methods, techniques, tips. I want you today to just watch, listen to whatever we have devised with our experience dealing with number of people. As I said, it is not rocket science. It is not theory. It is not philosophy. It is not from some textbooks. It is real life experiences. Now, based on these, if you can stimulate your mind, if you can start thinking, some of them would be directly applicable to you. Go ahead, try it out. Some of them you may try out and not succeed. Drop them. Move on to something else. Some of them you may say, this is not work. Evolve your own based on that. These are only food for thought. These are only seeds which you need to germinate and nurture and make into plants of your own. But take this thing seriously. Do it for yourself. Do it for your loved ones. And start strengthening, sharpening each one of your life skills so that you can lead a better life. You can have a harmonious family. And you can have wonderful relationships with people. And as and when that so-called vaccine and this, that comes, we will be all out again, meeting each other, shaking hands, hugging each other, roaming around all over the place. We will be looking forward to that with a lot of optimism and happiness. So here you are. Please see, watch, and get back to us if you have any doubts.
Good morning. Since you all know that Banjara Academy is an institution with an heart, Banjara Academy proudly presents our online courses. They are PGDP, that is Post Graduation Diploma in Psychotherapies. We have CCAT, that is a certification for child and adolescent development, and International Program for Counseling and Guidance, that is an online 1-year course. So we have many online courses this year. So please do join us, because at Banjara we believe in free counseling. But there are a lot of people who come to us saying that we would also like to become counselors. So keeping that in mind, we have come up with these online courses. Please do get in touch with us, or even call us, mail us. And if you are interested, please do join us. Thank you. Thank you.